We welcome any of you and all of you who might be watching at home, and hope you'll enjoy being with us this evening. We're thankful for all those that are gathered here on a cool afternoon as we stare down the race that is Christmas month. it's here. So even though we're still in November, it's still the decorations are up at my house. Are they up at y'all's house? Mm-hmm. Anybody still got work to do? Any husbands out there in trouble because they're not up yet? You hadn't got the stuff down off the high shelf? Look, I'm going to tell you, the best thing I've ever done, and Sherry will agree with this, I'm not just saying this because she ain't in here, the best thing I've ever done was, instead of lugging those Christmas decorations out to the shop or up into the attic as we have for many years wherever we've been, I bought a set of metal shelves that stand right outside our garage door coming in from the house. And they every single Christmas decoration we own is in boxes on those shelves. I want you to know I watched all the football games yesterday. I didn't barely have to get up at all. It was lovely. And I encourage you to find a solution that works at your house the way that seems to be working. And even better, I didn't have to put an empty box up for a month before I got it back down to load it back up. They're all right there. And Sherry's a wonderful woman. We already knew that, though. So. Well, guys, let me open us up in prayer, and we're going to get started talking about just the sermon series we just wrapped up about gratitude and how we glorify the Lord through showing Him the things that we are grateful for, the many things that we're grateful for in our lives that come from Him. Let's pray together. Father in heaven, Lord, we are thankful, God, just for who You are. God, for that You and Your holiness, you need nothing, you want nothing, you lack nothing. Because You are everything. And Lord, it amazes us that even in that, even in Your fullness and Your holiness and Your perfection, You choose to desire to have a relationship with us. And Father, we don't understand it all the time, and we never understand all of it. But Father, we're thankful for it. And we're thankful that You care for us enough to send Your Son into this world to not only die on the cross, but to live for so many years before that. To experience life as a created being, as a flesh-bearing being, as one who walks and talks just like we do and is tempted just the way we do. We're thankful that He never fell to temptation. God, as we celebrate Christmas this year, as we look at those wonderful events that we'll get to be a part of in our families and our community and our church and our businesses and schools, God, we thank You, Father, that in all of that we celebrate not only a Savior that was born in the world, but one that was not contaminated, was not lessened by His time in the world, but rather brought about the salvation of the world for all that would submit our lives to You. So, Father, we are thankful today. Lord God, as we have this time of discussion, would You be with us, Lord? Help us to grow and to communicate and talk and just share the ways that You are growing us, the things that You're doing in our hearts. Would You open our minds, our hearts to receive that encouragement from You and through one another? Lord God, in all of it, help us to grow ever stronger in our faith in You, ever more obedient, and ever more excited to do the things that You allow us to do and that You've called us to do. So, Lord God, we give You this time as an act of worship and as an act of expectant just action that You would be using to edify us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, guys, back at the second Sunday in November, which seems like a long time ago because Thanksgiving was sandwiched in there. It really wasn't but 3 weeks or 3 Sundays ago, 2 weeks ago. We started a series called Glory Through Gratitude. And we started off in Romans chapter 1, verse 20, making the connection between glorifying the Lord and being grateful and thankful for who He is and what He does. And in Romans 1, verse 20, we read, "For since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, His eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made, so that people are without excuse. For, in verse 21, although they knew God, they neither glorified Him as God, nor gave thanks to Him, but their thinking became futile, and their foolish hearts were darkened." And that's important. I think that connection's important. It definitely enriched my understanding of gratitude, thankfulness, and the way that I'm supposed to live that out in my life. When I saw in Romans there that those two things were connected. It's connected in a negative connotation, in a negative explanation of what's going on. It's connected in a way that's saying they should have given thanks, they should have glorified God as God, but people didn't. And even though God had put on, in verse 20, all they needed to know right before them, he puts it all in front of us, everything we need to know to see that we need to be pointed towards him, and that we don't need to be trying to do this whole life thing on our own. Like a lot of people today, they saw it, they might have even understood some of it, but they went their own way. And that connection is made between they neither glorified him as God nor gave thanks to him. And so for me, going forward, until God, you know, changes it in my heart and mind, glorifying him and being grateful, showing thanks to him, will be, you know, inextricably linked. I mean, you know, they'll always be together in my mind, and more so now than ever, because that's something that, again, is a kind of a newer connection that that God's made for me in my study and in my time in the Word. And so it's amazing to me that these two things, it seems so simple, doesn't it? I mean, obviously, when we're grateful for something that someone has done for us, or something that someone has given to us, we show gratitude by glorifying them, and we glorify them by showing gratitude. So why should God be any different? And so we looked at that, trying to figure out, okay, well, how can we, as followers of Christ, how can those of us who have called upon the name of Jesus to be saved and who are living in that eternal life that he gives us right here and right now, how can we show our gratitude and thereby, and through that gratitude, glorify the Lord? And so we started looking at a lot of different things, and we took over next into 2 Corinthians chapter 4, and we read in verse 7, it says, "But we have this treasure in jars of clay," talking about the treasure of God's gospel, God's love, his message for us, and salvation itself. And we talked about how from that verse, that eternal life, salvation that is available only in and through God, through Jesus Christ, is a treasure. And that we need to look at it as something to be grateful for. And then all the rest of the points in the sermon series through the next two messages and the end of this one, or that first one, ended up being things that gratitude does. So how can we go about showing our gratitude to God and glorifying him through that? Well, by doing these things. These are characteristics of what gratitude looks like when it's being given out, when it's being, you know, recognized, when it's being expressed towards glorifying the Lord. And we looked at a few things. We looked at that gratitude overflows, right? That it's not something that we keep down in us and hide. It spills out into everything. It's something that we want to share. That you know is you know, if you've ever filled up a coffee cup and not paid attention and got it to the point of overflowing, you can't stop that thing from overflowing quick enough, can you? I mean, it just pours out and pours out and pours out, and you think you've opened up a lake dam or something like that. You know, it may only be a few drops, but man, it feels like for those seconds that it's just overflowing forever. Well, how much more so should our gratitude overflow? In the second sermon, we looked at these three qualities and characteristics of gratitude: that gratitude speaks, it doesn't stay silent; that gratitude trusts, that it relies upon, believes in, and also that gratitude submits, right? And so submission is part of this in our showing our gratitude to the Lord for what he has done and who he's made us and how we glorify him. And then finally, to remind you from this morning, we talked about the fact that gratitude rejoices, gratitude appreciates, not just is thankful for, but understands and grasps what's going on, rejoices and takes joy in what's going on, what we're grateful for. And finally, that gratitude hopes, that we not only look at what God has done, but it gives us hope for what he will do and what he is indeed doing now. In the second and third sermons, we looked at two very important ladies in Scripture. One, Hannah from 1 Samuel, Samuel's mother, who had been without a child, who had been unable to give her husband a son and to receive a son herself. So she prayed fervently to God that he would grant her and give her and bless her with a son, and he did. And she made good on the promise she made that if he gave her a son, she would completely and fully and totally dedicate that son right back to him. And so her song comes to us on the day that she goes to do that very thing. Her son has been weaned. He's gotten to an age where it's appropriate to do so. And she takes him to the temple and gives him into the care of the priest and dedicates him to the service of the Lord for the rest of his life. And Samuel goes on to do great things in the Lord. And the Lord does great things through his ministry there in the temple and beyond. And then this morning we talked about another very important lady from Scripture, and that is Mary, the mother of Jesus. how she was in a very difficult, very uncertain, and very unexpected, in fact, impossible position. And I had to kind of, you know, as we always try to do, making it family friendly on Sunday mornings, had to be careful about what all we said, you know, and how we said it. But obviously, she was pregnant and was supposed to have never been with a man before. So something was off somewhere. Well, what was off was God changed the way that works in her situation so that Jesus could be born free from sin, not, you know, born into flesh, but not cursed by the sin that's carried on through generation after generation. So both of these ladies sing these songs to God in their gratitude. God has done amazing things in Hannah's life and in Mary's life. And the songs that we read and that we study and that we preached on and hopefully that we'll continue to revisit in our own personal study and personal lives, they remind us and they show us how we can glorify God through our gratitude. I think one of the simplest things we can talk about this evening, kind of looking back on this, is I don't want to, you know, just set you up for the Sunday school answer, right? I mean, I don't want to just say, hey, tell me some things you're grateful for, and then we all say Jesus, and we say, you know, all those basic, you know, Sunday school answers. You know what I'm talking about. The ones that, you know, the six words or the six names that answer every Sunday school question that's ever been asked. But I'd invite you this evening to take just a moment and to consider, it's a small group of us in here, so it shouldn't be too daunting to us, but to consider, what are some things that you are grateful to the Lord for? There may be some things, maybe some events or some happenings or some other type of blessing, maybe a person or some people. Who or what are you grateful for this evening? Does that mean you want Miss Chris to go first, or are you? You couldn't see it, Miss Chris. He was steadily pointing at you, so I think he may be grateful for you. What I couldn't see was whether or not you were poking him with your pen, no. You know, underneath the, you know, behind the pew there.
Have you seen the sign at Hickory Ridge Church?
I've not.
Have an attitude with gratitude.
Attitude of gratitude. Yep. Isn't it neat that those two words rhyme? Huh? It's graced a lot of church signs over the years. But boy, it's important, isn't it? Gratitude absolutely is an attitude, something we portray and something that forms actions and thoughts and reactions and everything else.
Well, of course, typical, like you say, family.
Sure.
Your children, your husband, your grandchildren, your friends. You know, but particularly this year for me, it is that I'm still here. You know, I came close to not being, so I am particularly
It's a different story once you've been so close to having things drastically change.
Yes.
And we're thankful that you're here too.
Kind of in that same boat, I thank the Lord every day. I know it's been a while. You know, when Jane was diagnosed with cancer, a lot of questions, a lot of unanswered questions. A lot of answers from the doctors that you hate to hear, the I don't know. We're not sure. I thank the Lord every day for allowing her to continue to have another day.
Yeah. Even if she did have to spend it with you, right, Minister? No, gosh, Jana, has that been 24 years? 23 years?
23 and a half.
Wow. And talk about something that changed your life. I mean, you know, you were in a totally different career field, and I mean, it's amazing how that has brought about ministry in life. You and I have talked about it a lot over the last couple of years. It puts you in some positions to minister to people that you might not have ever, you know, thought about, or you know, most people don't. Absolutely.
Yeah, I'm grateful for the strength the Lord gave Jen in the last 2 years.
She's been battling with it and battling hard, fighting hard, and winning.
You can still fight too.
That's right.
Yeah,
And I think anybody who has been through those types of situations knows that it is a fight. It is a constant battle. It's not something you put on the shelf and come back to later, is it? It's something you have to fight through, but it does.
Sometimes when you go through situations like that, like we've all been.
Yeah, Miss Chris has been there too.
For some reason, I didn't worry about tomorrow. I just felt like the Lord was going to cure me and I was going to be okay, you know.
Right.
And I didn't worry about, you know, okay, is this going to be my last day? I just felt like He was going to take care of all that, you know.
Right.
And He did. This has been since 2014, almost 8 years, so.
And it does. It gives us a perspective when we go through that we can't get any other way. And it certainly gives those of us who go through it with our loved ones a perspective, but it's not quite the same as the person themselves who either are going through that type of battle or have been through it. Praise the Lord that we're able to talk about it the way we are. All right. Well, good luck following those. I mean, yeah, amen.
That was tough.
This time a year ago was hard, wasn't it?
And the Lord has made it to where we can come, and we're not where we used to be, but that's okay. You know, we're progressing. We just ask God to continue to bless this church.
Amen. You know, as we've gone through Thanksgiving and some things a lot more normal than they were a year ago due to COVID, you know, it doesn't have to be life-ending possibilities to change our perspective. You know, I mean, think about it. The times when your power has been out at your house and you walked in the bathroom to go use the restroom and you flipped the light switch on, knowing in your mind it wasn't going to come on, but you flipped the switch out of habit anyway. And I think in that moment, each time I've done it over the years, I think about, man, how much I take for granted that when I flip that little plastic switch, lights come on and I can see whatever I need to see, right? And it makes me thankful for the very next time when the power does come back on that I can go in, I flip that same switch and you almost just go, now we're back to where we need to be, you know? And so it's big and small things, if you want to describe them that way. I think it's just things, really. I mean, you know, it all factors into our lives. But certainly over this past year, being able to gather together and do some of the things as we gather together that we're used to, still not quite exactly the same. And as Wayne said, we're missing some folks that we won't see again this side of heaven. But that's all in God's hands, too. And we're thankful that we can gather around while, you know, for the ones we are missing and be together and missing them, instead of just having to watch on a screen. If you're watching on the screen, don't feel bad. We're glad you're still doing that. But you do have the option, you know, and the opportunity to come in and be right here in person, too.
Sometimes I think we're not grateful for the things that the Lord gives us. You know, we just take it for granted or something.
Sure.
You know, we don't think to say thank you, Lord, for just one day, you know.
And sometimes we need to be faced with either the loss of some of those things or the potential of loss of some of those things or those people. Not that God doesn't mess with us in it. You know, He has a purpose, and He's absolutely planned it out to and how to deal with us and how to get our attention back. But He does get our attention back, doesn't He? That's, you know, it's hard, I think, and let's just be honest, we're talking about this idea of gratitude. It's harder than we think, or maybe we make it harder than that. Maybe I do, I don't know, to stay fully grateful and express that all the time. You know, I think about with my family, you know, I mean, how grateful I am for each and every one of them. And, you know, all three of those girls that live at my house, well, the one that kind of lives with us still, but you know, we sent her back off to school this afternoon. But those three girls that live in my house, I'm so grateful, you know, just for who they are and who God is continuing to grow them to be. But in everyday life, I don't always show it the way I want to, the way I feel it, the way I, you know, I don't always show it to the level that I am grateful, you know. And I think that's just part of who we are. I think that, you know, I don't know what a life would look like if we were able and were committed to showing that gratitude and not having to do anything else or not choosing to do anything else. I don't think any of us have ever really lived that life. So the question we have is, especially when we're talking about glorifying God for, and being grateful for the things he's given us and the things he's doing in us and through us, we've got to figure out, what does that look like for each and every one of us? How do we do that? How do we live that out? And so, you know, whether it be, you know, the characteristics that we've mentioned in the sermons, or something else, or some other way that God has revealed to you and how that works in your life, I think some things are pretty common. I think one, part of how we show our gratitude to the Lord is that we pray, that we spend time talking with him and hearing from him. We stay in his word. We study. We read for motivation, for education, for encouragement and all these other things. And then we serve, you know, and we're active in not just doing our thing, but in helping others. And that's, one of the great things about a church is that we have the opportunity to do those three things and more, you know, in a church. And so I think that it's, you know, that part of being, you know, grateful in our everyday life is to plug into those activities, to make sure that we're not, just every once in a while thinking about God, but letting him become more and more as we grow in him, the forefront of our consciousness, the forefront of what we're looking forward to, the forefront of what we're, you know, engaged in and what, who we're chasing after and everything that we're dealing with. Anybody else want to share anybody or anything that they're grateful for? Anybody got some? Man, yeah, Sherry said there were five this morning in there. That's a good bunch to have. Absolutely.
I'm grateful for being blessed enough to be born in this country. Being born somewhere else in the Middle East or somewhere, and the kind of chances we have. It's a big blessing to be born in the United States.
Not something we were able to choose, was it? Absolutely, was something that was beyond our control. Anybody else? Well, as we go into this week where the calendar will change to the month of December, and as we go through the things that will go on this week as God gives it to us, I want to encourage each and every one of you that the way you show gratitude and the way I show gratitude and the way that our neighbors show gratitude to the Lord for all he's done might not look the exact same every time at every moment. And I don't think it's how we show the gratitude that is important as that we show the gratitude that we have. Obviously, God can be glorified in so many different ways and avenues from each and every one of us based on who he has made us to be. Now, that doesn't mean that, you know, we believe a different gospel or that we preach a different message or that we're saved by a different means. We're all in common in that. But the way that God's glory is ascribed to him, the way that we live our life in our gratitude and show that glory to him and glorify him in our actions and our lives might look different from you to me to the next person to the next person. And that's okay. That's all right. Obviously, we know that from church to church and from person to person, we worship differently, but it's the object, it's the person whom we're worshiping that is important that we get right. And if we do, then the rest of it is a little bit more just details. And so the point of the glory through gratitude series is not to tell you a particular way to glorify the Lord in your gratitude, but to remind us all that we need to glorify the Lord through our gratitude, and that we need to increase in how we're glorifying him because we're increasing in how grateful we are to him. So this week, whatever God brings to you, the things that scare us to death, the things that make us smile and laugh, also the things that make us cry, and even the things that we get afraid of, let's be grateful to the Lord. And in our gratitude, let's glorify him for who he is, because regardless of what we experience, he is who he is, and he deserves every bit of glory we can ever give him, even if we spent every second of every day glorifying him, which is our goal. So I hope that as this week comes, you'll be finding yourself in situations where you can praise the Lord, glorify the Lord, grow in the Lord, serve the Lord as he takes you wherever he's going to take you this coming week. Man, Mr. JP didn't make it tonight. See us finish early. Look at that. He may come in. We'll see. But we're going to wrap up a few minutes early and let you guys get back home, get warm, and get ready for this week. And as we look to as a church and as a church family, glorify the Lord in our gratitude for all that he's done for us. Let's pray together. Lord God, we are so thankful. As again, Father, we could list off the many things, the many people, the many events and situations and blessings that we are thankful to you for. But Father, let us, as we think through those things, as the song says, as we count our blessings, Father, let us never lose sight of whom our blessings come from. So Father God, would you help us to see you in all of our blessings, because no gift, as your scripture tells us, is greater than the giver of it. And Father, we thank you, Lord, that you are the giver of all good things, and we have so much to be grateful for. God, show us more and more, whatever it takes, and that's a bold prayer for us to pray, but whatever it takes, show us more and more how much we have to be grateful for, and increase our gratitude in that. And Lord God, as we go, as you give us days to live in your spirit, in this eternal life that we've found, that you have blessed us with through faith in Christ, God, help us to grow in you and to glorify you more and more. For Lord, you deserve all of the glory, all of the honor. Don't let us save any of it for ourselves or steal it away from you to give to something or someone else. Let us glorify you because you are the one who deserves it. So Lord God, I thank you for each and every one that's gathered, whether they be gathered at home, watching online, or whether they be here with us. We thank you so much, Father, that you love them and you love each and every one of us and that you desire to work in us, on us, and through us. So Lord God, as we go forward in the days you give us, let that very thing happen. Work, Lord, as only you can. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.